Montgomery County officials and labor leaders worry the odds are against them if Ohio builds casinos. Pam Elliott shows you what gambling could cost our county.
Dayton won big when it hosted the National Scrabble Championship in August. It's the kind of gaming the president and CEO of the Convention and Visitors Bureau likes to see. But Jackie Powell is concerned about what might be in view after November's election.
I don't like to see Dayton not in with every other major city in the state.
Dayton has been left out of Issue 3. It's the question on the November ballot that calls for a constitutional amendment to allow one casino each in Cincinnati, Cleveland, Columbus, and Toledo. Powell's concerned if those cities end up offering gambling to potential visitors, Dayton will have less luck drawing certain events and could even lose some regulars.
We do quite a few military reunion groups here in our community. We've found that the military reunion groups, in some cases, really like the gaming factor.
But those locally who support Issue 3 says Dayton can still win on this deal. They say that this area can gain tax revenue and jobs.
I support the casinos, very obvious for jobs, you know, for the building trades, for building them. And then they'll be, you know, a lot of those jobs will be from local people.
Wes Wells represents the local AFL-CIO, a union with 40,000 members. He doesn't like to see Dayton left out either, but he sees great job opportunities, especially in construction, if casinos are approved for other parts of the state.
Well, I think that maybe the people should have been lobbying for one in Dayton. You know, if they were concerned about this, why didn't they lobby for it?
We're the only city in the state of Ohio, the only major city in the state of Ohio, really, that is not going to have that option. Whether the community would decide to do it or not, it would not be an option for us to consider at this point.
But would you encourage voters here to say no to Issue 3?
I'm not going to go there. It's, again, our board has not taken a position on that.
But the AFL-CIO local and state organization have endorsed a yes vote on Issue 3. And Wells is willing to bet you'll see more evidence of their support the closer we get to November. Pam Elliott, 2 News on your side.